sugar plums, welcome back to my channel. Today's guys, we're jumping right into the tutorial. Now this is the shelf bookcase or TV stand that I'm gonna be making over. I'll be using it as a TV stand because my TV don't go on top of it. It's in the wall and my TV is also mounted in the wall. Now this is from IKEA. It's one of the shelves that you can remove like the shelving inside and place it into different places. Now I'm showing you where I want to go ahead and place the new shelving. I'm gonna go ahead and permanently screw them inside, and you guys gonna be able to see why I'm doing that. Now after I mark on the place where I want to go ahead and put my shelving, I went and screw it with like two screw permanently, and then I'm gonna go ahead and use another shelving for a door. So basically it came out with two shelvings, two on each side. So I'm gonna be using just two shelving and use the other two to make doors for the shelvings. Now after I finish adding the first one, now I'm gonna place one of the shelving as the door so we can go ahead and make sure that we know exactly where it's supposed to be. And I'm gonna use the other one of the other shelving on top, and then I'm gonna go ahead and screw shelving in place. Now to attach the door, I got those hinges from Amazon. I'll put the link in the description box for you guys. And then all I'm doing right now is just align the door to the bottom part of the shelving. And because I'm working in a tight space, I went and closed the hinges first, and then I'm gonna just go ahead and screw them in place. Then after we finish, this is what the door is gonna be looking like. I'm being extra careful here guys because I haven't put the handle on the door yet, so it's hard for me to open it when I close it without the handle. So now that the door is completely done, now we're gonna go ahead and place the mirror on top. Now I was lucky guys, I went to IKEA and I found the exact mirror that matches my TV stand. And this is the mirror guys, if anyone or one of you wanna buy it and you need to know what kind of mirror it is, this is the mirror. And I'm gonna go ahead and use some E6000 to glue it on top of it. You don't have to use E6000 guys, even silicone, anything that can glue on glass or mirror will do perfectly fine. Now I'm using a decent amount, and then I'm gonna go ahead and place my mirror on top of my TV stand, and I'm gonna be using some very thick books and some clamp to make sure that it stays in place, and I'm gonna leave it overnight like this. But I'm gonna go ahead and continue working on the side. And for the sides guys, I'm gonna be using three different type of mirror. I went and cut 1 centimeter by 7 centimeter and 1 centimeter by 3 and 4 centimeter, and the other one is just gonna be some random cut size mirrors. It doesn't have to be any specific shape. Now first I'm gonna go ahead with the longer one, that's 1 centimeter by 7 centimeter, and I'm gonna place those both at the top and the bottom part of the side of the TV stand. Now I'm just making a pattern guys, you don't have to do something like this. If you're trying to make that makeover, you can do whatever you please. So like I say, decoration, design, it's just subjective, it's personal taste. So this is what might look like after I place the long mirror. I'm gonna go ahead and repeat with the small mirror on the long side of the TV stand. And then after we finish, we're gonna go ahead and move on. And then now this is what it's gonna look like. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take a wooden ruler that I have, and I'm gonna place it in the center, and I'm gonna trace that part to remove that part, because at this part that's gonna be in the center, I'm not gonna put any mirror on it. I'm gonna put something else inside it. So that's what I'm gonna do. That's what I'm doing right now. One thing guys, I use a permanent marker and it's red, so when I use some glue later on to glue my gem on it, the marker kind of bleed out a little bit, so keep that in mind. Make sure that you try to use something that's not permanent, and then you can remove it before you do the next step. Now this is what both sides gonna be looking like. also went and cut like low square piece of mirror and put them on the long side of the front part. And then for the top part, I'm gonna go ahead and make another pattern. And what I did is I cut like a big square piece or rectangle piece, and then I cut like a tiny piece I'm not gonna cut it even, so I'm gonna cut like a big piece and a smaller piece, and I'm gonna place the smaller piece on top, and then I'm gonna put the bigger piece on top, and the smaller piece at the bottom. Now, because we're making a pattern, guys, I'm just gonna go ahead and alternate them, you know, like the way I did the first one. I'm gonna alternate it and put the smaller piece on top and the bigger piece at the bottom, and keep doing that until we completely finish the whole front side top part of the TV stand. Just that way it's like gonna be visually more pleasing and it's gonna look way better. Now, this is what it's gonna be looking like, and we are almost done with adding the mirrors to our TV stand. Now, the only piece of mirror I'm gonna be adding to the TV stand is gonna be the very top shelf, the part that doesn't have a door. I'm gonna go ahead and cut some square pieces again. I'm gonna do 5 on both, on each side, plus I'm gonna have a longer uncut mirror in the center, just again to give it a more interesting look. So I'm gonna go ahead and, after I add my 5 pieces on each side, I'm gonna go ahead and add some E6000 in hot glue, and I'm gonna place the longer side of the mirror in the center. Make sure leaving some space between the square pieces and the big mirror, because later on we have to add some paste to connect everything together. And again, guys, I'm using some books and some clamp to make sure the mirror adhere really well to the bookshelf or the TV stand. Now, this is the next morning, and I'm gonna be using my again sparkling paste. Guys, you can use grout if that's what you have, but again, that's what I have at home, and that's what I'm gonna be using. I'm gonna go ahead and add my paste to all my places that have the mirrors, just to go ahead and fill up the gap and connect them and give it again a more interesting look. Now, if you don't want to do this part, all you have to do is make sure when you place your mirror, you just connect them. You don't have to leave any space. If you don't leave any space, you don't need to add either paste or grout. Now, this is the next morning, everything is dry. Now, all you need to do is take like some clean water and some kind of towel. I'm using a microfiber piece of cloth, and I'm gonna go ahead and use it and remove all my paste to all the side of my mirrors. And this is what it's gonna be looking like. It looks fantastic, I can say that. I love it already, guys. Again, like I said before, if you don't like a lot of blings, you can just go ahead and leave it like this, and just leave, add more mirror in the center, and you can leave it like this. It's perfectly fine. You just, change your TV stand and it is gonna be looking just fine like this. I think mirror always bring like, a very nice look to any furniture. Again, it's personal taste. Now, for the side of the mirror, to be able to add my gem in the middle, now I'm gonna go ahead and place a foam on that side, and I'm gonna flip it upside down, just because I don't want to break my mirror. That's what I'm adding the foam for, the stand to stand on top of it. Now I'm gonna go ahead with silicone glue. Guys, you can use Mod Podge if you want. I didn't want to use Mod Podge because I wanted my glue to dry faster. Silicone glue is thicker and it dry faster, and for me it's more forgiving than Mod Podge. So after I finish adding my loose little gem, those are tiny little loose gem, guys. Again, I got those from Amazon. I'll leave everything in the description box below for you guys. And then while this is drying, my stand is still on its side. I'm gonna go ahead and use the same wallpaper that I use on the two side shelf that I made last week, because it's gonna be a set. I'm gonna use the same wallpaper inside the whole thing together, guys. And if you're new here, guys, thank you so much for stopping back. And if you're one of my old subscribers and you're here, guys, thank you for being here. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to go ahead and subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon to be notified on all my new uploads. Now, guys, this is a few hours later. Everything is dry. Both of the side of my shelf have the gems on it. Now, to go ahead and clean up that part, I'm gonna go ahead and use the same sticky gemstone that I bought from Amazon, and I'm gonna use Oturo. Basically, guys, what I'm trying to do, because I'm trying to make a set, I'm trying to make the stand kind of look the same as the shelf that we made last week. Makes sense, right? So I went and do like a border around like those jam just to clean it up and give it a more neater and finished look. So I'm gonna go ahead again and create borders around all the part that have the mirrors, and I'm gonna be using the sticky gems stone that I had. And you can see I love that thing so much, guys, because it brings a lot of shine. If you love shine, guys, you definitely need to buy this, guys. Trust me, buy it. Now, to clean the inside part, all the corners and edges where we have the wallpaper, again, we're gonna be using a Oturo of bling wrap in the silver color, and I'm gonna go ahead and add that to clean up and make it look really nice without seeing, you know, all the part where we glue the paper. Now, after we finishing adding all our bling wrap and our sticky gemstone to all the part that need to be on the mirror and on the wallpaper, this is what the stand look like. Now we're gonna go ahead and start working on the doors. Now, for this part, guys, like you see, I didn't have enough wallpaper, so I added another wallpaper on the inside. It's gonna be on the inside anyway, doesn't really matter. Now, for the edges of the part that have the doors, I'm gonna be using that black and diamond wrap, just because I'm gonna leave the door to be black, and you know that I think the contrast, instead of putting like a regular bling wrap on it, it will look much better. So I'm gonna be using this wrap on both on the top, and this is when I close the first door, and then I'm gonna be doing the same thing also for the bottom shelf drawers, if you call it that way. Now, the bottom part of the drawer, guys, the way I put it together, I wanted to have that almost like that bezel edge. So that's why you're seeing it like this. It's closed, but it's not inside the drawer itself. Now I'm gonna be using those onlays. Surprise, surprise, yes, they are from Amazon, and they are acrylic mirror, and they have like a sticky back. All you have to do, guys, is peel them, put them on top of whatever you're using them, and you're good to go. Now, I had those for a while. I never used them, so I decided to put them on the door because I wanted the door to be, you know, have some shine and some interesting look on it, but I didn't want to add a lot of like bling wrap or something like this, or change the color to silver. I wanted to have the black in it. So I'm gonna go ahead and use it, making a pattern again, going across the drawer door, and then after we finish, this is what it's gonna be looking like. Now I'm gonna go ahead and use a two row of the same sticky gem stone again, and I'm gonna go ahead and add one at the top and one at the bottom, and we're gonna go ahead and repeat the same process for the bottom drawer as well. Now I'm adding just some on it just because I wanted to have a bit more shine to it, because those are mirror, they're not shiny, but once we're done, this is what it's gonna be looking like. The door look fabulous. Now for the side of the part that have like a very big space on it, I didn't like the way it looked. I wanted to have an open space, but I wanted to have like some type of separation, so you know, I can put different things in it, it still have like a separation even though it's like an open space. Now I'm using very thick dowel, and all I'm doing, guys, I cut them to size, and I make sure it's a very tight fit. I'm not using any glue or any screws. All I'm doing is place them inside, and I'm twisting it until I put them in place, and this is what they look like after I finish. And I decorate them with some strings of the same diamond wrap and the sticky gemstone, and also I went and added like a piece of gemstone on top of like the screw on the dryer handle. I forgot to show you guys this part. Now we are completely done. It was such an easy makeover, guys, and it looked fantastic. I love the shine. I think it looks great. It's gonna look beautiful when I put everything together on my wall. Again, guys, those gonna be floating shelf, floating TV stand, so that's it's gonna look. There's not gonna be like any heavy stuff on top of them, but I'm pretty sure you can put like a TV on top of them, as long as it's not one a big TV that's like 70 pound or something like this. You don't want the mirror to break. Now this is what the makeover for this week look like, guys. I'm gonna be putting more makeover for you guys and showing you how I makeover my feature wall that have the TV stand on it. So guys, I'll see you next week for this one, guys. Thank you so much for being here. Don't forget to go ahead and subscribe to my channel, please. I will really appreciate that. Hit the bell icon to be notified on all my new upload. If you like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment as well, guys. I love you so much. And until next time, guys, I'll see you soon. And as always, be blessed and stay blessed. Mwah! I love you. Bye-bye.